Make your Excel chart true interactive by incorporating dynamic ranges and a scroll bar. These dynamic ranges adjust based on what your audience wants to see, while the scroll bar allows viewers to easily navigate through different data points. In this example, the scroll bar is used to reveal monthly figures over a 12-month period, altering the number of months reported and serving as a dynamic range for the chart's data source. To begin, insert a bar or line chart using some data similar to that shown in the video. The cell C1 dictates the number of records displayed on the chart. The cell C2 will be linked to the scroll bar. Go to the Developer tab and in the Controls group click Insert drop-down and select the scrollbar icon to insert a scrollbar. Once you have inserted a scrollbar, select it and move it onto your chart. Right-click on the scrollbar and select Format Control. In the Format Control dialog box, navigate to the Control tab. Adjust the minimum value field to match the value in cell C1. For example, if cell C1 contains the value 4, enter 4 as the minimum value. Set the maximum value field to match the total number of data rows. For instance, if there are 12 rows of data, enter 12 as the maximum value. Assign the cell link to cell C2. This cell will reflect the position of the scroll bar. Now, we create a dynamic named range. Go to the Formulas tab and click Define Name icon. The New Name dialog box appears. Enter monthly underscore sale in the name field and in the refers to field enter the formula appeared on the screen. By using the offset function, you can use cells C1 and C2 to force the referenced range for monthly underscore sale to expand both up and down as the number in cell C2 changes when the scroll bar moves. In other words, changing the number in cell C2 to the number 5 would force the range to incorporate B7, B10. Next, define another dynamic named range and name it horizontal underscore axis. In the refers to box, type the formula as it appears on the screen. This formula works similar to the previous formula, we just changed the starting reference point B6 to A6. Next, right-click on the chart and choose Select Data. Select the Sales Series and click the Edit button. In the Series Values box, enter the dynamic range monthly underscore sale. Click OK. Next, edit the axis labels. In the axis label range box, enter the second range name horizontal underscore axis. Click OK. Click OK again to close the Select Data Source dialog box. Doing this will make your chart dynamic. The resulting chart will look like this. Thank you for watching. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more Excel tips and tricks. And remember to hit the notification bell so you never miss an update. For more in-depth tutorials and Excel insights, be sure to check out my other videos. See you in the next one.